people ask me table about Rav Nachman in Bresa, no doubt became very popular, Baruch Hashem, thousands of thousands visit his grave in Uman, and more followers, no doubt that his ideas become more and more, many languages. So we looked for a table, and amazingly we found Rav Nachman Bibresev there, an interesting location, and also interesting things coming around. So let us see what the table tells us. So in the table we see here, as you can, if you look properly into this table, you will see the following. You will see here, clearly coming, the words in black, Rav Nachman and Mibresev in red. By the way, this is the only best meeting of Rav Nachman Mibresev that one can see in a table, as all the other meetings cannot be seen in proper table. So no doubt this is insignificant. Now what is the most interesting in this case is that we see here the location. Location is when Moshe Rabbeinu Moses was in Mitzrayim, and we know all what was going on with Pharaoh, the 10 plagues and so on. So the story of Egypt, Exodus, comes here also. Then amazingly comes here also the story of the acceptance of the Torah, Kabbalah Torah in Sinai. When the Torah says here that Moshe Rabbeinu went down to the nation, Vayered Moshe in Ha'ar Elam, from the mountain Sinai came to the people and made them ready to accept the Torah. Then Vayitzak El Hashem was crying and praying to Hashem when Jews were in troubles. So looking this is interesting, the location. Coming out of Egypt, in Egypt, Moshe Rabbeinu, in all these cases, and as it is known, Rav Nachman ben Bresev, as I said, the spark of Moses, of Moshe Rabbeinu. So no doubt the connection is clearly seen here. But what is the most interesting, perhaps the most important, is what we see here on the basis of this table, which says tshuva, repentance. We know quite well how much material Rav Nachman had about repentance, especially speaks about Psalms, Tehillim, which is really the gate, the opening for repentance. So tshuva, repentance comes here. Now what's the most interesting? That tshuva comes here, as you can see here, every seven letters in a verse which speaks about the Shabbat, which is the seventh day. Sheshet yamim asa shem melacha lo tasu en zen lo bayom ha-shvi'i Yilachem Kodesh. So clearly says the pasuk Sheshet Yamim Teaseh Melacha. 6 days work should be done, but on the seventh day Vayom HaShvi'i Yilachem Kodesh should be holy. Now amazing that it comes here with seven letters, should be the seventh day of Shabbat, and Tshuva comes inside those letters of Shabbat, telling us that the most important thing really is keeping Shabbat. It's our Rebbe said us in the merit of keeping properly two Shabbatot, Messiah Mashiach will come. And so no doubt that looking here on this table, Rav Nachman Mibresev appears, and as we said, the story in Egypt for Moshe Rabbeinu, doing everything to bring Jews out of Egypt, and preparing them for Sinai, for the Torah. So all this, with the tshuva, with repentance, which is the most important, we know quite well, to have Mashiach, we need the condition, as the Maimonides says, of tshuva. So, as I said, people wanted to know whether it appears, and we found out amazingly that it appears in this place only once in the Torah, as can be shown beautifully in these guys. And let us hope that really we'll do tshuva, and then Mashiach will come soon in our time.